So, dear student, I Rakesh Jain from Gyanvihar University. Today, I am going to teach you about the timer in 8051 microcontroller. In case of 8051 microcontroller, basically there are two timers. Timers, why we use the timers? Because in certain operation, we have to provide the time delay. For example, let's suppose we want to generate a square wave in which the on time period is 10 millisecond and off time period is 5 millisecond. So to generate a square wave, that is very simple, 1 and 0, 1 and 0 we have to generate. But here there is a concept of time delay of 10 millisecond and 5 millisecond. That's why we require the programming related with the timer concept. After the completion of this lecture, you will be able to understand about how many types of timers in 8051 microcontroller, what are the registers which are related with the timers, and how to use them. So first of all, I just write down about the basic timer. In 8051 microcontroller, basically there are two timers. In 8051 microcontroller, there are two 16-bit timers actually. In 8051 microcontroller, there are two timers. So one timer is known as timer 0 and one timer is known as timer 1. One timer is known as timer 0. One timer is known as timer 0 and the other one is known as timer 1. Basically these timers, the function to perform by the timers are, there are two functions basically. Timer can be work as a timer to provide the time delay, and they can be used as a counter to count, for example, the number of pulses in a particular bit of time. So that is, timer can perform two functions. One is as a timer and second one is as a counter. In 8051 microcontroller, timer, two functions. Basically, it performs two functions. One is timer and one is counter functions. One is timer and one is counter. Why as a timer and why what is the meaning of function as a timer and what is the meaning of function as a counter? Whenever we want to provide a time delay, then it can perform as a timer, and whenever it we want to count certain number of pulses, whenever we want to do the counting operation, that time the timer can be work as a counter. So in 8051 microcontroller, basically there are two timers and both are capable to work as a timer to provide time delay, as well as they are capable to as a counter. So now what are the registers which are related with the timer operations? So basically there are two registers. So registers related with timer operations. Basically there are two registers which are related with the timers, and these are TMOD register and TCON register. Both are of 8-bit registers. We will see their format and understand the meaning of them. So one is the TMOD register and the second one is TCON register. Second one is TCON register. Basically, there are two registers which are related with the timer operation. One is the TMOD register and second one is the TCON register. First, we see the format of TMOD register and understand the meaning of that one. So TMOD register, it is basically an 8-bit register. It is basically an 8-bit register in which the format is like 8. Oblique P bar M1 M0, then again gate C oblique P bar, bar I will create right now, M1 content M0. So this is a format of, now I create the bar over there. So C oblique T bar. Okay. So this is a standard format of the, these 8 bits can be represented as a bit of T mode register. Gate C/T bar M1 M0, gate or C/T bar M1 M0. The 4 LSB bit are related with the timer 0 operation, and the 4 MSB bit are related with the, yes, the 4 LSB bit are related with the timer 0 operations. These 4 bits, I am talking about these 4 bits from here to here. These 4 bits, gate C/T bar M1 M0, are related with the timer 1 operation, and the remaining 4 bits are related with the timer 0 operations. Okay. So whenever these four lower 4 bits can be used, the LSB 4 bits are used, it means we are talking about, we are using in programming the timer 0 for our operations, maybe as a timer, maybe as a counter. Or if the upper 4 bits, MSB 4 bits are used in our operations, then it means in programming we want to use the timer 1, maybe as a timer or maybe as a counter. So, and the second register, then later on I will explain the complete format of this T mode register. First I just draw the T cone register also, so you will understand. First of all, I'm going to draw the second register format, that is T cone register. You also note down the format of this register in your textbook. Now see, this is the format of TCON register. It is also a 8-bit register. After the completion of drawing of this format, I will explain you about the complete knowledge of TMOD register and TCON register, how to use them in our program. Okay. So now see the format of second register, that is TCON register. It is also a 8-bit register. That is your TF1, TR1. First I write down the name. TF1, TR1, TF0, TR0, IE1, IT1. So this is the complete format of TCON register. Here, this register can be used during the time of timer operations, as well as this register is also important during the time of interrupt operation, because the lower 4 bits which consist to the subscript I is related with the interrupt in interrupt. Okay, so it will be used during the time of interrupt operation. You will see later on during the time of that unit how to use that AS triggering, and for AS triggering it can be used. You will see later on. First of all, just to draw the format of, yes, so this is a format of TCON register, in which the TF1 means timer 1, or 1 means wherever I use TF1, 1, TF0, 0, TR1, TR0. So wherever I use 1, it means I am talking about timer 1 related thing, and whenever I use 0, it means I am talking about the 0, timer 0 related. Okay, so TF1 means timer flag bit overflow, that is timer 1 overflow flag. I just write down what is the meaning of TF1. TF1 means, here I write down. Here I am going to write down TF1 means timer 1 overflow flag. Timer 1 overflow flag bit. Okay, so this is timer 1 overflow flag bit. That is TF1. Okay, so TF1 means timer 1 overflow flag. Similarly, now what is the TF0? That is timer 0 overflow flag. What is the TR1? Timer 1 run control bit. Timer 1 run control bit. TR1 means timer 1 run control bit. Similarly, what is TF0? Timer 1 overflow flag. Sorry, timer 0. What is TR0? That is timer 0 run control bit. Now what is IE? IE is stands for the interrupt operation. So what is IE1? That is interrupt 1 edge flag. What is IE0? Interrupt 0 edge flag. What is IT1? Interrupt 1 type control bit. Okay. So I just write out timer 1 edge flag IE1. That is timer 1 edge flag. What is IT1? What is IT1? IT1 is interrupt 1 type control bit. It is not timer, it is interrupt 1 edge. Interrupt 1 edge flag. Edge flag bit. Okay. And what is IT1? That is type control bit. That is related with the type control bit. So, interrupt. During the time of interrupt operation, we will use these 4 bits. Then you will easily understand what is the meaning of them. But you should remember about the format meaning. That's why interrupt 1 type control. Similarly, what is IE0? Interrupt 0 edge flag. What is IT0? IT0 is interrupt 0 type control. During the time of programming, we will see how to use them and what are the meaning of them. So this is the explanation of the basic explanation of the TCON register. Now we complete the TMOD register explanation. So see, I am just going to remove about this TCON register. So there will be some space. So take a snapshot of that one. So you can write down on your text copy. So that is the explanation of the timer related and interrupt related edge flag, type control bits, overflow flag bits, and run control bits. That's all about the TCON register format. Now I'm going to explain the TMOD register format. So I'm just removing this one. And now just see the TMOD register format. So this is timer mode register. Now what is the meaning of these C/T bar? If on C/T bar, if there is 1, it means we are using the timer as a counter. Now which timer? Because it is related with the upper 4 bits. That's why timer 1 as counter. If on C/T bar, if there is, we put 0 during the time of programming, then it means we want to use timer 1 as timer to provide the time delay. Timer 1 is a timer to provide the time delay. Similarly, if I use the lower C/T bar, from the LSB, if I use the C/T bar, it means I want to use in my programming timer 0 for my operation. So if there is 1, it means timer 0 can be used as a counter. And if there is 0, it means timer 0 can be used as a timer to provide the time delay. So if there is 1, it means timer 0 as a counter. I'm at 0 as a counter. If there is 0, means timer 0 is time. So that are the basic meaning of the C/P bar. Now what is the meaning of this M1, M0? If I use M1, M0 are used to select the which mode we want to use the timer. Basically there are 4 modes to use the timer during the time of programming. Timer can be used to provide the time delay in 4 basic modes. Mode 0, that is also known as 13-bit timer mode. Mode 1, that is also known as 16-bit timer mode. Mode 2, that is known as 8-bit auto reload mode. And mode 3, that is known as split timer mode. So which mode we want to select for a particular timer, that can be done with the help of M1, M0 bits. So see, M1, what is the meaning of M1, M0? So if I use this upper M1 and M0, it means I am talking about the timer 1 mode. And if I am using M1 and M0 of the LS from the LSB side, it means I am talking about the timer 0. But the meaning is same for M1 M0. So what is the meaning of this M1 and M0? See, if both are 0, 0, if M1 is 0 as well as M0 is 0, it means mode 0, timer used in mode 0. Okay, mode 0 is also known as 13-bit timer mode. Mode 0 is also known as 13-bit timer mode. That is also known as 13-bit timer mode. So in bracket I am going to write down about that 13-bit timer mode. 13-bit mode. So you understand this one? Mode 0 is also known as 13-bit mode. Now, if I use at the place of M1 for 0 and for the M0 if I put 1, it means that is your mode 1, means timer used in mode 1. And what is the meaning of this mode 1? Mode 1 means 16-bit timer mode, 16-bit mode. That is 16-bit mode. Now the third one is, if I put at the place of M1 as 1 and M0 as 0, then it is known as mode 2. This is known as mode 2. And what is the meaning of mode 2? Mode 2 means 8-bit auto reload mode. Lack of space, I just remove. Once again, I am typing this one. So 0 and 1 means mode 1. Mode 1. That is also known as 16-bit timer mode. Next one is, if M1 is 1 and M0 is 0, it means mode 2. Is also known as auto reload mode, 8-bit mode, or we can say 8-bit auto reload mode. Auto reload mode. And the last one is, if both are 1-1. So if both are 1-1, then it means, first I separate them so you will not be confused. Okay, the last one is 1-1. So if this 1-1 means split timer mode, that is also known as mode 3. Which is known as split timer mode. Yes. So that's all about the M1, M0 concept. Now, if the m1 m0 of the corresponding upper must be m1 m0 are used as in this four basic sequence whatever we selected for the programming, then it means timer 1 as mode 0 or timer 1 as mode 1 or timer 1 as mode 2 or timer 1 as mode 3. And if the m1 m0 of the lower side, from the lower side of this tmode register is selected as 00, it means we are talking about timer 0 as mode 0. If 01, then timer 0 as mode 1. If 10, it means timer 1 as mode 2. Or if 11, then timer 1 as mode 3. So that depends on which timer we used. Okay. Now the last one is gate. The gate, generally for the programming, we just put 0 over here. Okay. Because we are doing the on-chip programming. So remember, keep in your mind, generally without the interfacing of with any device, if we use the timer to provide the time delay and we use the concept of tmode registered, then we should put gate is equal to 0 due to the on-chip programming, because we are doing on-chip programming. Yes, so we generally put 0. So that is the format of tmode register. Now before we are going to start the concept of the programming of 8051 microcontroller, first of all, there is the most important some programming sequence, some calculation sequence after which we are able to do the programming. So what are those certain steps for the programming? I am going to teach you right now. So to create the space, I am removing certain files from here. Okay, I just save this one and reopen the new one. Okay. Now some steps, some calculation steps are required. Whenever we are going to do the programming for to provide the time delay in case of 8051 microcontroller, we have to provide, because 10 millisecond, 3 millisecond, certain specific data, specific time delay we have to provide. So how to achieve that time delay? With the help of certain calculations. So what are the calculations? For what the calculations are for? The calculations are for number of count. Okay, actual number of count. So how to find out those calculations? Remember, in 8051 microcontroller, the standard crystal frequency is 11.0592 megahertz or 12 megahertz. In certain questions, in certain operations, if for example 8089C51, it may be 22 megahertz. So I just write down first of all, the step number first for the timer calculations is, timer clock frequency. First step you should do, timer clock frequency. Timer clock frequency should be equal to, because 1 upon 12 multiplied by crystal frequency. 1 upon 12 multiplied by whatever the crystal frequency. The standard crystal frequency for the 8051 microcontroller is 11.0592 megahertz. If in question it is given, for example, if you are going to do any competition exam or any main examinations, if there is a question of programming and if crystal frequency is given 11.0592 megahertz, then it's okay. If not given, any crystal frequency is not given in the question, then you should choose the standard crystal frequency, that is 11.0592 megahertz. Okay, so you will be able to find out the answer of step number first, that is timer clock frequency. If 12 megahertz or 22 megahertz, any other from 11.0592 megahertz is given in question, then you should use the given frequency only. Okay, that is 22 megahertz or 12 megahertz or whatever it is given. So timer clock frequency is 1 upon 12 multiplied by crystal frequency. The second step is each clock period. each clock period. We have to calculate in the next step each clock period. So each clock period is equal to 1 divided by timer clock frequency. So whatever the answer of step number first, you should write down here, timer clock frequency. So that is 1 divided by timer clock frequency. Okay, so each clock period is equal to 1 divided by timer clock frequency. For example, let's suppose you have 22 megahertz crystal frequency. Then what is the answer of step number 1? I just find out megahertz mean 10 to power 6 will be multiplied. Okay, so I just calculate from the calculator and telling you. So what will be the answer of if 22 megahertz, then it will be 1.833. okay, so 1 divided by, it will be 0.4546 microsecond. Okay, now the third step is delay is equal to number of count multiply by each clock period. Each clock period is the answer of step number second. Number of count multiply by each clock period. So from this step, you have to calculate the number of count first of all. You have to calculate the number of count. Then the last step is, what is the actual number of count we should upload in the timer register? That is the actual number of count. The last step is actual number of count. That will be calculated as maximum number of count minus number of count. Number of count means step number third answer minus number of count. So the actual number of count can be calculated as maximum number of count minus number of count. So from these four steps, you understand that to find out a delay of any particular time, how to calculate the number of count. Now what we will do after the calculations, we will upload these actual number of count in the timer registers, in the timer registers. Okay, now remember the timer register which I taught you just before. I'm just showing you the same. See there, that one. Yes, here you understand that there are two register, timer 0 of 16 bit and timer 1. There are two timers, timer 0 and timer 1, both are of 16 bit. Remember, there are, I just write down here also, so you will understand that in 8051 microcontroller there are two timers and both are of 16 bit. Okay, both are of 16 bit. Okay, now timer 0 and timer 1, so they further splitted into two basic 8 bits subparts. Okay, timer 0 and timer 1, they both split into subparts. The higher order bits of timer 0, that is TH0, and they are 8 bits, the MSB 8 bits, the higher order 8 bits of timer 0 can be abbreviated as TH0. H for higher, T for timer, and 0 for timer 0. So timer 0 higher order bits, 8 bits they are basically, and timer lower 8 bits. So TH0 and TL0 are known as timer 0 8 bits, so total 16 bits. Okay, similarly timer 1 is further splitted into two basic subparts, that is higher order 8 bits and lower order 8 bits, so total 16 bits will be there. The higher order 8 bits are known as TH1, timer 1 higher order 8 bits, and the second one is TL1, that is timer 0 low, sorry, timer 1 lower order 8 bits. So this is TH0, TL0, TH1, TL1. These are known as timer bits. So now how to upload the value in those timers? What value we should upload? That value can be calculated by these four steps. These value can be calculated by these four steps. For example, how to upload the values during the before how we can find out these values. Now let's suppose I wish to I am giving you an example so you will understand about each steps and what is how to upload in TH0 and TL0. Okay, now see what is the first step. Let's suppose there is a program. Okay, so there is a question that what value should we load in timer register 0? Okay, timer register 0 to provide a time delay of 10 milliseconds. To provide a time delay of 10 millisecond and crystal frequency is given as let the crystal frequency is, if not given in any question you should choose 11.0592 megahertz, otherwise whatever given in question you should use that one. Okay, let crystal frequency is 22 megahertz. Okay, this is my question. So what value we should upload in a timer register 0 for programming to provide a time delay of 10 milliseconds? Okay, and crystal frequency is given as 22 megahertz. Now see very carefully, what is the crystal frequency given? Crystal frequency is 22 megahertz. So what is the first step? See this one, this is the first step. What is the first step? The first step is timer clock frequency. So I'm just calculating for this question and you will easily understand. Okay, now see very carefully. So timer clock frequency I should calculate for the first number step. So timer clock frequency is equal to, I don't bother about the caps lock or clock frequency is equal to 1 divided by 12 multiplied by crystal frequency. Now what is given? 1 divided by 12 multiplied by crystal frequency. What is crystal frequency? 22 megahertz. 22 megahertz means 10 to power 6. So it will be timer clock frequency will be 1 upon 12. 22 divided by 12. So I just find out the answer with the help of calculator. So 22 divided by 12, it will be 1.8333. okay, 1.8333 multiply by 10 to power 6 is there. Okay, so 1.8333 multiply by, okay, multiply by 10 to power and 6 is also there, so power there is 6. Okay, so it will be the answer of step number first. Now what is the step number second? You just see this complete question. The second is each clock period. So what will be the each clock period? Now we are going to check this one. Each clock period, that will be equal to 1 divided by timer clock frequency. 1 divided by timer clock frequency means step number 1 answer. So 1 divided by, what is the step number 1 answer? The step number 1 answer is 1.8333 multiplied by 10 to power 6. So I just copy and paste here. Okay, so 1 divided by 1.833 multiplied by 10 to power 6. So what will be the answer? This 10 to power 6, when go at the upside, it will be 10 to power minus 6, because we are going to find out the period, it means time. So that will be as a microsecond. Okay, okay, so what if 1 divided by 1.8333, it will be 0.546, or 0.545 we can say. So So let's suppose the it will be 0.546. Okay. Now it will be microsecond. It will be microsecond because 10 to power minus 6 will also be there. So what is the step number second answer? The step number second answer is 0.546 microsecond. Okay. Now what is the step number third? See very carefully step number third. Step number third is delay is equal to number of count multiplied by each clock period. I am just writing down again. Delay is equal to number of count multiplied by each clock period. Number of count multiplied by each clock period. Okay, so delay is equal to number of count multiplied by each clock period. Okay, now see what is the delay. What delay we have to provide? It is given in question. To provide a time delay of 10 milliseconds. See very carefully, time delay of 10 milliseconds. It means millisecond means 10 to power minus 3. So what is the delay? Delay is given as 10 multiplied by 10 to power minus 3. Delay, what is delay is given? Delay is 10 milliseconds. It means 10 multiplied by 10 to power minus 3. Is equal to number of count. So number of count we have to find out. So number of count is the unknown thing. So I just write down that it will be equal to number of count. Multiply by each clock period. So what is the each clock period? Each clock period we have already been find out in step number second already. So what it will be 0.546 microsecond. So 0.546 multiply by, because microsecond is there, it means 10 to power minus 6 will be there. Okay. So from this step we have to find out number of count. So what will be the number of count? We can easily found out. So number of I move at the left hand side. So 10 into 10 to power minus 3 divided by, see very carefully, divided by 0.546 into 10 to power minus 6. So what will be the answer? We just find out this 10 to power minus 6, when go outside, then it will be 10 to power plus 6. So with the help of calculator, I am going to find out. So 10 to power minus 6, whenever move at the numerator side, then it will be 10 to power plus 6. So 10 to power minus 3 will be minus, so 10. So 10 and then 3 times 0 will be divided by 0.546. So it will be 18315. It will be approximately 18315. 18315 will be the answer of step number 3. Okay. 18315. You just see from the calculator that step number 3 answer will be 18315. Now the last step. What is this last step? Actual number of count. Now see very carefully this last step. Actual number of count is equal to maximum number of count. Now see, timer can be used in four basic mode. Mode 0, that is 13-bit timer mode. Mode 1, that is 16-bit timer mode. Mode 2, that is 8-bit auto reload mode. So in 8-bit mode, we can provide the maximum count as 2 raised to the power 8, that is 256 only. So it is more than 256 because 18315 is there. So that is very large compared with mode 2. value, so we cannot use mode 2 here. Mode 3 is split timer mode. We cannot use that mode also. Mode 1 is only the 13-bit timer mode. So 2 raised to the power 13 will be there. So which one is the most convenient mode for the operation of timer? That is mode 1. That is 16-bit timer mode. It means 2 to power 16. That will be 65536. Okay. So generally we use mode 1. So the maximum number of count for mode 1 is 65536. Remember, the maximum number of count means 2 to power 16. 2 to power 10 is your 1024. I'm calculating this one. And the 2 to power 6 means 64. So when we will multiply, we will find out 65536. So remember always, for all kind of numericals, whenever you use mode 1, generally we use mode 1, okay? If not mentioned specifically. So if mode 1 is used, then the maximum number of count is 2 to power 16, because it is also known as 16-bit timer mode. 2 to power 16 is 65536, okay? So 65536 minus 18315. So what will be the answer of this? The answer of this one is minus 18315. So the answer of this one is 47221. 47221. So this is the actual number of count. Now, what is my question? My question is not that what actual number of count you should find. The question is what value should we upload in a timer? Okay. So what value? So remember, after finding the step number fourth answer, you have to find out the hexadecimal equivalent of that answer. Then that value will be uploaded. So to find out the hexadecimal equivalent value, we have to divide the number by 16. You just wait for 2 or 3 minutes more, this will be completed. Okay. So I receive a message. Okay. So you just wait for 2 or 3 minutes more, then we will complete our topic. So the hexadecimal value for this 47221, we have to find out. 47221. How to find out? You know very well. So 47221 divided by 16. So it will be 47216. Okay. So it will be 2951 times. Okay. 47221 divided by 16 will be 2951 times. Okay. 2951. So what will happen if I divide 2951 times, 2951 times, then it will be 247216. Okay, so 16. So 5 will be remaining. 5 will be remaining. Okay, you just you know very well that how to convert the hexadecimal. So 5 will be remaining. So I just write down the remaining value here. Then again divide the number by 16. Divide the number by 16. So what will happen to find out the hexadecimal? 2951 divided by 16. So what will happen when 2951 is divided by 16? 184 times. We'll divide 184 times. So 7 will be remaining. Yes, 7 will be remaining. We just find out the hexadecimal equivalent of that one, nothing else. Then again divided by 16. So what will happen? Yes. So 8 will be remaining. Okay. Now the hexadecimal equivalent. This 11 in hexadecimal and known as B. Okay. So from lower to upper we find out. So what is the hexadecimal equivalent of 47221? That is B875. H is for hexadecimal. Now what is my question? My question is what value should we upload in timer register 0? Because timer register 0 is given. It means two registers, one is TH0 and one is TL0. If timer register 1 we are talking about, then TH1 and TL1, but here timer register 0 is mentioned. That's why TL0 and TH0. Now, what value should we upload? The value is B875. How? The upper 8 bits of B8 will be gone into TH0, and the lower 8 bits of 75 will be go into TL0. So my answer is B875. So from this way, we have to calculate the value first of all before the programming, that to provide any specific time delay. These four steps, and after the final answer, we should convert it into hexadecimal. Then we will start our programming, because we know that what value should we upload in the timer register to provide a particular time delay. In this numerical, to provide a time delay of 10 milliseconds, what value should we upload? B875 value should we upload. Okay. So I hope you understand about the concept of timer, the timer register, T-mode register and TCON format, and also the important calculation steps for the timers. So thanks for watching the video. I, Rakesh Jain from Ganwar University, wants to say thanks for watching the video. Kindly like and subscribe the video. Thank you very much.